Hello everybody, welcome back to another Adobe Premiere Pro 2022 tutorial. This one, I'm going to show you how to green screen like a professional. And I'm going to do it very, very quickly, and I'm going to try not to skip any steps. So just roll with me, let's go. Here's the original footage here on the left side, I'll show you. And if you look at it, you're going to say, hey, that looks very poorly lit, and there's dark spots and creases on the on the green screen. You're right, it's very, very badly lit, and it's deliberately chosen, because if you can green screen this, then you can green screen anything, really. And if you've got a homemade setup and you don't have three-point lighting, don't worry about it. I'm going to show you how to get around all that stuff. So anyways, I then screened it here, and then just to show you what the final output looks like, here I put a red background behind it, and there we go. So let's just start from scratch. So I'm going to delete all of this stuff, including all of these other pieces, so that you can see how it goes step one to end. Okay, first step, bring in your footage like I've done here into the project panel. Drag and drop it onto the timeline. Presto. The next step is you want to go to your effects panel. For me, it's right here. If you don't see it, go to Window. Make sure there's a check mark beside Effects. Now go to Ultra Key. If you type in Ultra, you'll see under Video Effects Keying, Ultra Key. Drag and drop that on there. When you do that, nothing happens, but you want to now head over to your Effect Controls panel. So for me, it's over there. Again, if you don't see it, make sure there's a check mark beside it. Okay, we're in the effects control panels. We're going to go down to Ultra Key. Ultra Key allows us to do a lot of things, but what the big one we want to do first off is adjust the key color. It defaults to black, which is of no value. Left click on that, and then I'm going to go ahead and left click on this stopper, and then now when I drag it, you'll see the eyedropper still selected. And I'm going to select a green, but notice that I'm not selecting a bright green. I'm selecting a dark green because it's easier to go ahead and adjust darker colors than it is to adjust properly lit colors. So we're going to pick a harder color like this green here. All right, good stuff. We're in composite, and you can see here that, well, we got rid of this outside edge, but here is obviously not correct. So let's just start getting to work here. So we're going to drop down the first one, which is matte generation. And we're going to go ahead and adjust the highlight. Watch what happens. When I adjust the highlight, we can adjust it to zero, and we get an interesting effect. So I'm going to drop down to zero for now, and I'm going to increase the transparency. Let's see where we're at. Let's increase the transparency to about, let's go to about 50 for now. You'll see here that it's still got a bit of a background here, so we're not where we want to be. Pedestal is one. If we jack that up, we want to jack that up to about 32 for this example. Again, we're trying to get rid of the background color, but leave her in the shot. So let's just scan through it now. And we're getting there. It's actually pretty close. 50, 0, 50, 50, 32 for this one. Okay, good stuff. Now, let's do a check here. So we're in Ultra Key. The output set to composite. I'm going to go ahead and adjust it to alpha channel. Now take a look here when I scan through it. It looks pretty good, but you guys have probably seen green screen footage with the sparkly effect in the shoulders and sometimes in the head and the hair. Well, I can guarantee you that's happening, because if you look at the composite, you see some gray in here with the white. So we're going to try and get rid of that. So let's go ahead and just start hitting some buttons here. So for me, I'm going to go ahead and increase the transparency a little bit past 50. So I'm going to go to about, change that. We're going to go to about 37. Let's see what this looks like. Do we see any of the gray? Okay, nope. The pedestal, if you're not sure, you can always move it up a little bit. I like to keep it pretty high just because you might lose a little wisp of hair or two, but that doesn't really matter in the long run. So let's go back to composite. Okay, let's take a look now. Hit spacebar. Okay, we've got her in a spot where I'm pretty happy with it. This is all these other things here, matte, spill, and color correction. Matte and spill suppression are not really necessary in most cases. Color correction is interesting in this particular shot because she's not very well lit. So what I like to do in this one is I'm going to increase the luminance so that she looks like she's been lit from a front-facing camera. And luminance is for light. Basically just means how much light is being let in. So let's take a look at this. Okay, I like this. I'm going to go ahead and export it. So I'm going to go to File, Export, Media. All right, good stuff. Now this is incredibly important. Do not skip this step. You're going to notice that for me, it's set to H.264, high quality, 1080, whatever. This is not correct. What you want to do is you want to switch down here. There's a few different options, but the one I like to use is easy, is QuickTime. And importantly, and this is incredibly important, the preset that you select needs to say with alpha. So for this one, I've got Apple ProRes 4444 with alpha. You need that alpha channel because the alpha channel is the transparency channel. So when that's ready to go, I'm just going to go ahead and zip this to, I don't know, let's go set it to movie. You want to set it in movie? Sure, we do. Why not? Who cares? And then hit export. Good. Now, we're going to run one quick test on it. So I'm going to go ahead and grab that video. So where did I put it? In movies? Yeah, in movies. And maybe it's, which one is it? Is this one or that one? I think it's this one here. Bring that one in. There we go. I'm going to go ahead and put this on a track, video track 2, just to test it. Again, you don't have to do this. There's 99.99% chance you did it right, but just in case, I'm just going to take a look, and then for me, I'm going to create a color mat, and I'm going to make a red one. This isn't stuff that you need to know how to do. I'm just showing you that the effect worked. So I'm just going to create the color mat and put it underneath, and we're going to test it. So here's the output, and it looks pretty good, guys. That's how you green screen terrible footage inside Adobe Premiere Pro 2022. Thanks for watching. Be back soon.